Hi folks, co-tutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the next video on MVVM design pattern in Android. In the previous video, we have seen how to implement the repository design pattern and back it up with a simple SQLite database. And to keep it simple, we did not use the Room framework. In this video, we will now move on from the repository to view model. So it is all about how to implement a view model and connect it with the repository. To be precise, we will not be discussing the concepts of the view model itself. We have already covered that in the previous videos of this MVVM design pattern series. What we will be looking at in this particular video is how we will use those concepts to implement a actually functional application. For example, this is the screen that we have seen for quite some time now, where we were implementing a to-do application. On click of the add button, we basically add a to-do. Then we basically need to show all the added to-dos in the screen. So we basically need a get to-do list. And then we have another screen which will be navigated to based upon what you click on the individual list item. And in this case, initially, when we go to the next screen, we want to show which one was clicked. So we need to have a get to do functionality for that. And then, of course, you can remove that. For that, we have remove to do and the modify to do functionality. If you are coming from a classic MVC or MVP design pattern, the immediate temptation is to create two separate view models for these two screens. However, that is a wrong approach when working with a MVVM. If you do this in MVVM, you are basically not leveraging the advantage of MVVM design pattern. The biggest advantage of MVVM over MVP or MVC is the view model can be shared across multiple screens or views, if I may say so. So with this approach, what actually happens is it increases the code reusability across the application for multiple screens. So what it means is, instead of having main activity view model and manipulate activity view model, we would have a one single common view model that would be used across multiple screens. So how would this translate into actual code? Well, this is how it would look like. We will have an interface called as common view model, where we will define the functionalities that would be used by the view model, which will in turn invoke with the repository. You can actually see that we have add to do and get to do list, which are both from screen one. Get to do, remove to do, and modify to do, which are all from the second screen, are also in the same view model interface. And that is why I said you can have one single view model that could be shared across multiple screens in the application. You can observe that the get to do list returns a live data, because that is what the view will be working with. The same is the case with get error status, which is basically used for maintaining appropriate error messages that we need to show on the screen. And other than that, we also have get to do, which returns a live data of to do for the purpose of second screen. So enough of conceptual discussion. Let's have a look at the code to see how this looks. So this is the same old code base, and now you can actually see that I have an interface called as common view model, and that extends lifecycle observer, and this is part of the view model package that I have created here. And what does it contain? It basically contains three methods which is returning different kinds of live data. One returns a to-do list, another returns a string error status, and third one returns a live data of type to-do. And then we have various functionalities for adding, removing, and modifying to-do. And other than that, we have another method called as refresh data. And this refresh method is basically linked with lifecycle event onResume. This is basically associated with lifecycle observer feature that we have discussed earlier in the MVVM design pattern series. Now we will be creating a class that implements the common view model. So you can see here that I have a common view model implementer which extends view model and also implements common view model that we had just defined here. So let's pay attention to what this class implementation looks like. It is pretty straightforward class. We have some instance variables here. Most of them are of mutable live data type. Other than that, we have a instance of the repository. We have already seen the repository implementation in the previous video. So in the constructor, it is all about initializing those instance variables, including the repository. And after that, I am initializing the mutable to-do list from repository.getAllToDos. And if something goes wrong, I basically want to set it with the empty array list. That is about the constructor. And now coming to add to do, no prizes for guessing. Using the repository, I invoke the add to do item and pass the appropriate parameters. And after I add it, the list would have got updated. So I need to get hold of the new list. So to do that, I will once again use repository get all to do's and get value, and I set that to the mutable to do list. And if something goes wrong, once again, whatever the error message that I get in the exception, I would set that to error message dot set value. And remove to do is once again pretty straightforward. You remove the item, and after removing the item, whatever the to do mutable live data that we are maintaining, which will be shown in the second screen, that would be set to null. And after remove, it is modify. Once again, it is pretty simple. Using the repository's modify to do item, I will just modify the item. And then after modifying the to do item, I will have to update the mutable to do live data. So once again, I am getting it from the repository. And if something goes wrong, once again, I set the error message. So that was about basically the functionalities that we had in our application, that is add, remove, and modify. Other than that, whatever the live data that we have, those need to be exposed so that they can be used in a activity or a fragment to actually render them. To do that, we have a method here, which is called as getToDoList, which returns a live data. You can observe that even though the data type that we have here is mutable live data, once again, we are not sending the mutable live data, we are returning a live data. If you are wondering why, just go back and visit the video where I have discussed about why we need to do this. And in the same way, case of getErrorStatus, it returns an error message. Once again, it is of type live data string, and getToDo returns a live data to do for the purpose of screen 2. Other than that, every time the screen loads in the onResume method, there is a possibility that the data might have got refreshed. So to keep your data up to date, whenever the screen loads in the onResume, you want to make sure that you have always perfectly synced data. And that is why I have written another method here, refreshData, that is basically annotated with lifecycle event onResume because of the interface lifecycle observer. And I have discussed this before. Basically, what happens is this refreshData method would be invoked in the onResume event of the fragment or the activity with which this view model would get attached to. So that is the whole purpose of annotating the refresh data with on lifecycle event. And what is happening here, it is once again just loads the all to do's from the repository and sets it to the mutable to do list, which would be returned using the get to do list method. That's all, nothing more than that. And with this, we have successfully implemented the view model. The next obvious question is how this view model would be used with the activity or the fragments. That is something that we will discuss in the next video. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.